Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I think we have around 13, 14 people, what I can see. Today, Uzair and Akshit are going to render a session on Apache Camel. I think most of you are aware that this is something related to application integration, and it is now, and on the top of that, it is open source and it is very powerful. So I hope you will get at least something so that it will help you to kick off further learning from today onwards. So I'll request Akshit and Uzair to just share your knowledge through this knowledge sessions, and rest of will be enriched with through your session. Okay.
Thanks, Uzair. Thanks. My screen visible? Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Hello everyone. Good evening. I am Uzair, and today me and my colleague Akshit are going to give a session on topic Introduction to Apache Camel. Before going to start with the session, let's first look into the Nodeless etiquettes. You should be punctual. You should respect the session timing. After the session, don't forget to give feedback. It will be very helpful for us. Please be in silent during the session and also avoid unwanted chit chat during the session. Moving towards our agenda of the session, first we will look into the part what is EAI, EIP. Then we will see an overview of Apache Camel. Then we will talk about features and architecture of Apache Camel. Then we will take a look on the Camel context. And finally, we will show a demo of how Apache Camel works. Let's begin our session with EAIA. Enterprise Application Integration is the task of uniting the databases and workflows associated with business application to ensure that the business uses the information consistently and that changes to core business data made by one application are correctly reflected in others. As we all know that most of business uses several software products from different vendors in their day-to-day operation. These applications can have different uses, data store, and also methods of operation. This can create a large number of data where either it is duplicated between databases or is available in one but not in other. EAI provides a methodology that helps these disparate applications share data and workflows to reduce manual steps and error and to provide better insight into organizational data. EAI can help to remove manual steps and reduce user error. Now, what is EIP? Enterprise Integration Pattern is a catalog of design patterns for developing system to integrate new and existing software in a business environment. A design pattern is a general solution to a design problem that recurs repeatedly in many projects. A pattern describes the problem and its proposed solution and discuss any other important factor. EIP focuses on messaging pattern for enterprise application integration. Messaging pattern defines the mean by which different elements in a message passing system connect and communicate to enable interaction among objects within programs and among various type of software, which may be in different languages like Scala and Java. Now, why we need EIP? As we all know that applications are heterogeneous in nature. They are developed using different languages, runs in different operating systems, understand different data formats. Application undergo a lot of change. They are subjected to under upgrades and their API changes over time. Also, they need to exchange data over networks in a reliable and source secure manner. Now let's have a look on Apache Camel. Apache Camel is an integration library for Java. It provides a set of Java APIs which helps you integrate and process data between different computer systems. In other words, Camel is like the glue between different applications. You can think of a Camel like a plumbing toolkit for data. Camel can take data from one application and pipe it to another. Along the way, the data can be changed, transferred, as well as sent through other pipes. Including in your plumbing toolkit is a range of adapters. These are called components in Camel, which fit all kind of applications and software system. Component in Camel helps you to integrate data from lots of different places like data in web services or even data in files or disk. You can even connect Camel to web apps like Twitter and Salesforce. Now, why we use Camel? Whenever you need to move data from A to B, you can probably use Apache Camel. Here are some scenarios where you can implement all of these with Camel, usually just few line of codes, like pick up invoices from your corporate file server and email them to customers, move document from your hard disk into Google Drive, take incoming customer order messages from a queue and use them to invoke a web service, turn some XML documents into CSV file, and also make a web service which serves product information from a database. What are the features of Apache Camel? Apache Camel provides the following features, like it is a very lightweight open source. It requires easy configuration. It also helps in routing and mediation engine. It is a DSL domain specific language, and it works on the enterprise integration pattern EIPs. Now let's talk about architecture of Apache Camel. The Camel architecture consists of three main components: integration engine and router, processors and components. This is illustrated in the following figure. The Camel core itself is a very small and contains 13 essential components. The rest are outside the core. This helps in maintaining a low dependency on where it is deployed and promotes extensions in future. The processor module is used for manipulating and mediating messages between endpoints. The EIPs that I mentioned earlier are implemented in this module. It currently supports more than 40 patterns and other useful processing units. The processors and endpoints are wired together in integration engine and router module using DSLs. While wiring these, you may use filters to filter message based on user-defined criteria. As mentioned earlier, you have several options in writing these rules. You may use Java, Scala, or even XML for this. Now we come to the most important component of Camel, which may be considered as the core, the Camel context. Camel provides a runtime engine called the Camel context, which run your integration. It's like a mini application server, which embedded inside your Java application. When you work with Camel, you define your set of integration pipes in either Java or XML syntax, add them to the Camel engine and start the engine. Then you can leave the engine running and it will continue running your integration until you switch it off. The Camel context runs your integration and is generally responsible for moving data throughout the system. The simplest way of starting Camel is to create an instance of default Camel context and call the start method as shown in the figure. Now, what is roots? One of the main reasons to use Camel is when you want to integrate system and application together. To use the same plumbing analogy from earlier in this section, we want to use Camel so that we can run pipelines which move data from one place to another. In Camel, these integration pipelines are called routes. A route usually consists of a series of steps. The first step receives or fetches some data, and then the data is passed through subsequent steps to the end of the route. You don't have to run a route directly. Routes are configuration objects defined in Camel using a Java or XML syntax, and then they are added to the Camel context. A simple route definition looks something like this. It can be of any language like Java, Scala, and Spring. Endpoint. When writing integration routes in Camel, you will often need to interact with other systems. In Camel, an endpoint is an interface through which Camel exchanges a message with another system. Camel can receive a message from an endpoint or send a message to an endpoint. Endpoints are the physical representations of the external application in your routes, and you declare them using a URI. For an example, at the start of a route, Camel will receive a message from an endpoint. The endpoint might be a file endpoint which reads a file on a disk. Then message might be processed or transferred in some way before being sent to another destination endpoint. An endpoint is a Camel route generated by a component. Components, as you will see next, are Camel's connector that allow it to interact with external systems and application. Components. To allow Camel to create an endpoint, it uses a component. A component is simply a specialized plug that allows you to connect to an external system, such as a file, Mailbox, or an application like Dropbox or Twitter. You can think of a component as a factory for creating endpoints. Whenever you want to move data in or out of an application, you will probably find that a camel component already exists to do the job for you. This means you don't need to waste time writing your own code to read a file or invoke a web service. Just find the component you need and you can use it. Components are reusable, they are open source, and you can even create your own component. Now, here is the Apache Camel dependency. Now, Akshit will show you the demo how Apache Camel works.
Okay, thank you, Zay. Now I'm sharing my screen. I hope it is visible.
Yes.
Okay. So in this demo, I have chosen a very basic example so that any person can understand it very easily. So let's start with our pom.xml file. Here I added a dependency for Apache Camel, that is Camel Spring Boot started with the 3.16.0 version. Okay, so move on with our code. So I create a simple class here, a Spring Boot Camel application that extend a root builder. So root builder is a base class which is derived to move which is derived to routing rules using the DSL. Okay, so here I configure I override a configure method here where we set our actual root. Okay, so a camel root starts with from method and it ends with to method. So that code present inside the parenthesis is called URI. So generally URI has three parts. So first part is a file. So file is nothing but it is a component in Apache Camel world. So second part is a data input. So that is an actual path where we are going to read the file's format. So that particular part is called the context path. And third part is question mark. So in question mark, where we provide the additional options for the particular URI. So here we use noop is equal to true. So noop is equal to true is used to avoid the consuming the same file again and again. Okay, so in second folder we have already those files, so that will not be copied again and again using this. Okay, so in this demo we will see three ways to copying the files from one folder to another. Okay, so in first way we will copy all the files from the source folder to the destination folder. Okay, so here we have two files in the input folder and this is the output folder. It is empty now. Okay, so let's run this program. Okay, so you can see here both files are copied in the output folder. So using the second way, we will copy the file using the file name. So we use here filter. Okay, so we use here filter dot filter and header dot exchange file name. It starts with the file name. So we enter here the file name. Okay, first we create a new file here. Okay, hello. Java. Okay.
write some text here, which is Java. Okay. So we are write the name, the file name here. Hello. Okay, so any file with start with hello will be copied in the second folder. So you can see here, the hello Java file is copied in the output folder. So now in our third way, we can copy the file using the file content. Okay, so we have changed this to the body. So create a one more new file. Okay, so this file name is file 3. So we write some text here. So I now find here that's content that is start with the file. So run this. So you can see here the file 3 is copied in the output folder. So and also we can change a .txt file into CSV file. So there are lot of use of Apache Kernel. So that's all from this demo. If you have any queries, you can ask, or also you can ping me. And I write some several. I write some tackles on Apache Kernel. You also can go through with them. So thank you, guys.
Anyone have any queries? I don't think so anyone have any queries.
And in our next session, we will discuss about how we can expose the REST APIs using Apache Kernel. So if you have any queries, you can ask, or you can directly ping to me and Uzay.
Hello, Bharti.
Hello, Bharti. Hello. Let me. Thank you. Anyone from L&D?
Let me ping her.
I already done. So if any question is there, I think you can type as well. So, Uzair and Akshit, are we done with the content or we have anything else to?
No, I think it's over.
Okay, I think L&D is not able to connect. So I think I enjoyed the session. I think rest all have same feeling what I have. So. It's good, good, and I think if any doubt, any query, please put in chat section. So at least we, Uzair and Akshit can understand with respect to what is still something which needs to explain. So we have time, and they can explain on those queries as well. No one has any query. Interesting. So since I think we are good to conclude, if we don't have any query.
Yeah, if anyone have query, they can ping also anytime.
Yeah. Thank Akshat Uzair. We enjoyed your session. And I think in future, you will come up with more knowledge with respect to Apache Camel or any other topics. Yes, really, we enjoyed the session.
Okay. Yeah, thank you. Thank you all.
Bye.
Sure. Yeah. Thank you.